Hello and welcome to part two for this page, Lion and Luna Moth. So today we'll be finishing the page. It will be the final video for this page. We're going to start off here with coloring in that Luna Moth in the middle. So I am using my Prismacolors, my go-to pencil. And so let me know if you have any questions or comments down below. And I'll be popping in and out throughout the video, explaining what I'm doing as we go along. Right, so here I've got out my Neo 2 in Greenish Blue, and because the background is so small, these little tiny spaces, I'm going to just go ahead and grab the pigment from the crayon itself and apply with my water brush. So I basically fill in these little spots along the sides pretty solidly, but then up at the top I kind of make a gradient where it fades to a lighter shade towards the top of the image. You'll see once I get to that point. But basically right here I'm just blocking in the colors. And you can apply a second coat once the first coat dries if it's not dark enough to your liking. You can easily put down a second coat. I did that in some areas, and so that works really, really well. Alright, so here's where I'm working on fading the color out towards the edge of the page. And basically, I just load up my water brush start towards the lion's mane, and then let the color just fade out as I work towards the edge of the page. It's pretty much that simple. All right, so here I'm using my Tooli-Art Paint Pen from the Pastel set, number 23. And I'm just going to go around the lion's mane and in his face and just add some extra highlights. Now, the paint pen can kind of get a little thick in some areas. So a little bit later on, once I'm done adding those highlights, I go back in with my Prismacolor Colorless Blender and just kind of scratch off a little bit of that paint pen in some areas just to make it a little thinner. If I got a little carried away in some areas, you can kind of scratch it off or tone it down with that Colorless Blender. It works really well. All right, so here I've grabbed my clear sparkle Spectrum Noir brush pen, and I'm just going over all of that Luna Moth with it just to add a little bit of glitter, kind of a shimmery look to it. Any sparkle brush pen is fine, or if you don't have one, it's not absolutely necessary. I just always like to put a little bit of glitter on a page. All right, so here I've grabbed my ruler and I am just marking out about a centimeter out from the image to start creating a border. And so I just basically use my ruler for that. And here in a little bit, you'll see I ended up putting approximately 1-inch binder underneath the book because I needed a little bit more support there for creating those lines. And so then I grab my gold metallic Posca pen and fill in that border. All right, so once that gold metallic Posca has dried completely, I am going back in with my Micron fineliner in 03 or whatever size you decide to use, and just kind of tightening up that border, just making some nice line work there on the inside and the outside of that border. I mean, that's, you know, optional. It's up to you if you want to do that. But for me, it just makes it look nice and neat and tidy. Right, and here I am just erasing any residual pencil work. So that completes this page. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time. Take care.